Camden with Monarch tonight. We're here with Building Giants.
Hello.
Hello.
Let's quickly, first of all, talk about the glamorous life of a touring band.
Ooh.
Now, you guys have just spent 3.5, 4 hours.
Was it pushing six hours?
Oh, wow. I was asleep for part of it, that's probably why.
I'm moaning about it being a hard day, sat in the back, not driving.
So you've spent all that time travelling on a Friday afternoon, on the railways of the UK, which are so you get here 5 minutes before sound to jump on stage to sound check.
Yeah.
About 20 minutes after,
It's not so glamorous if you look at it, you know, through our eyes.
But at the end of the day, the main thing is you guys will be on stage in probably the next half an hour.
Yeah.
And you're going to play a show like you're playing in front of 10,000
people.
You've got it. And that's the best thing, I think, about live music these days. A lot of the new bands that are coming through,
show we played was in July, it was early July, and then we've just gone playing gigs ever since, so it's
been pretty full tilt, hasn't it?
I was going to say, it has been pretty full on.
Yeah, so it's only been nine, ten months, so yeah.
But obviously before that, I take it you guys were in various other bands?
Yes.
We've all been in bands in the past.
So me, Tom and Matt were in a band together before this one, without Joe.
And we failed. And then we thought, where's success lie?
We found this guy, we saw this guy. A bassist singer, that's what we need. That's what's popular these days.
Was it just the Giants, and now what we see walking is now
the Building Giants.
This is Building.
That makes a better story of us sticking out.
I thought it was a Building.
It was a Building.
I haven't listened to too much stuff because I wanted no preconceptions of you guys. So I'm looking forward to tonight.
Thank you very much.
A bit like the guys watching this maybe for the first time, seeing you guys for the first time. I want that same experience. Because it's exciting, it's lovely.
Absolutely.
From what I've heard, even the sound check, a very short sound check, it's a lot better than
We'll take that.
We'll take it, yeah.
We'll not be too loud about it.
I mean, this is a long way for you guys to come.
It is, yeah.
You've played London a few times now.
Mainly a lot in Camden as well. Yeah. It's such a good place. There's so many really good venues here, and like iconic venues. And we're kind of trying to get, you know, around all of them. So we did Dublin Castle, which has got a lot of musical background with loads of different bands like Muse.
That's where they got signed, innit?
Apparently, yeah. And then loads of bands have played there, so it's iconic venues which I'd love to play, and the lads obviously wanted to play, so we have them.
And you've got just next door to us, the bathroom. Well, it's now Camden Assembly, but used to be the bathroom. That's another iconic venue.
There's loads around here.
So many bands that I've known over the years from the States have come over. Like you say, Camden is an area where they love you, live music.
It's nice to do almost a bit of a spiritual tour of where all these bands that are kind of some form of inspiration or like where music is now played.
I think in the last 10 years, Camden has turned around again to be like a new iconic place for music. Even venues like the 100 Club, it's iconic. It's steeped in history. You walk in, it stinks of piss.
And you're like, this is perfect.
Yeah, that's what you want.
You go in the toilets and you just cry because it's, eyes are stinking, but it's steeped in the history of rock and roll.
I love that kind of stuff.
If it ever changed, if it ever cleaned itself up, you'd be upset because it wouldn't be that place.
I like the fact you guys want to experience the history, like short travel and history.
Massively.
Footsteps of Giants.
Exactly.
There you go.
Other people to do the same. With your music, is it like a blues rock type of style?
I'd say so.
There's an element of your voice is quite kind of growly, quite bluesy maybe. There's an element of...
There's wonders for the vocal cords.
Especially after a pint.
I mean, I've met a lot of young British bands over the last couple of years, and there's a lot of great music. The bands are very, very good. Each band is individual as well. There's no sort of clones in each other.
Yeah.
And that's what I find very, very promising for the future of British music.
Definitely.
Bands like yourselves and these other bands that I'm meeting.
Yeah.
It's strong.
I've been following, there's a page on Facebook I was following recently, and it's like, it's about like the new age of rock.
Yeah, new wave.
Yeah, which is awesome. And I was looking through all of them, there's so many different bands, and I was listening to all those different bands, and it is,
yeah.
It's so refreshing to see a new kind of age of rock coming out now.
And yeah. So many people not in those bands who are actually engaged with it and really like it.
I think it's a place of support.
Fingers crossed, yeah.
So I mean, so with London Info, have you guys got festivals planned? Or festivals?
Yeah, well, we just played a festival called Highest Point, which was in Lancaster. That was in conjunction with BBC introducing. And then we've got a few more coming up. The Sonderfest, which is in Manchester, which is based around a lot of the pubs around Manchester. So
yeah, more venues,
yeah.
So it's a bit like a Camden Rocks.
Yes,
exactly.
So we're playing at the Red Shed, which we've played at a few times. It's a really good venue. It's got a proper good stage. And, every time we played that, there have been some of our best gigs to be there.
So Deggy, who plays in Gorilla Riot, messaged me on Facebook at about 2 o'clock in the afternoon saying one of the main bands has dropped out, can you headline on the Thursday on the festival?
So
I was at work at the time, so I had to ring around these lot. Tom was in a meeting, so I got him. It was.
All on you.
I had to pick up all the gear in my Ford Focus. All the gear.
We can't let him down. We can't let Deggy from Gorilla Riot down. We need to do this.
I'm much better at Tetris now. So that's kind of what it was, getting all that stuff in my car. Man. But yeah, we did that, and it was a brilliant night, to be honest. It was well worth the stress of actually doing it, you know.
So. I guess also you've got fans up there, brother fans, not necessarily.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about, though. The reason you do all these shows, obviously, it's fun. We enjoy performing, but also you want to go to different places because you want to play to a new audience, and you want people to not like your music.
And also, whether there's 2 people in the room or 200,
it doesn't matter. It's New Year's.
Those 2 people, and who they're going to talk to.
You've got to play every show like you're playing to 10,000 people, otherwise it doesn't work.
Yeah.
The most exciting, I suppose, thing that we've got coming up is, in fact, that we're playing a festival called Blackthorn Festival, which is in Stockport, with Pete Doherty, which should be pretty cool. Playing with some, there's a few decent names that are on that lineup. That's in July, so that's a particularly exciting one. But I wouldn't say that we play that festival where we're hoping there will be a heck of a lot of people there.
Yeah.
Wouldn't play it any different to a show that we don't know how many people are going to be here tonight.
That's what we have. Hopefully,
And then afterwards, you'll be signing.
Exactly.
Obviously. Those gigs you have that are obviously a massive opportunity because you have a kind of captive audience. They're in the festival.
They can't get out.
They can't run away from you while you're playing.
They can't escape, yeah. I mean, we shouldn't lock people in more often.
You're talking about playing like you've been playing in front of 10,000 people. Fans, whether they're there to see you or not, you will know if you're making
a mistake. Of course.
Oh, you feel it.
Yeah.
You massively do.
I mean, we've talked this a lot of bands, but the vibe that the band is put off to the audience.
Yeah.
If it's right, the audience will give it back to you. And it's like a symbiotic relationship, and it works both ways. And it creates just an amazing atmosphere. For you guys, as well as people watching.
Obviously, you
feed off it,
you kind of, I was going to say, you play every gig like you play into 10,000 people, but then if the crowd are giving something back, it just, I don't know, there's something, there's kind of nothing better than that.
Of course, there's only so much.
Engaging with it.
I think with us, and the reason why we play in front of like we're playing for 10,000 to be, because we enjoy our music so much. Yeah. If you don't enjoy your music and stuff like that, you can only take so much out of it, but we take a lot out of what we're playing and we enjoy it.
We have to believe in what we do.
Of course,
exactly.
Which we do, so you know,
even at practice. Yeah. I wouldn't even say we're that different in practice. No, no. Really, we're not playing
still
in front of anyone.
Yeah.
Still giving it a fair amount.
Yeah, when there's a crowd absolutely roaring, loving it, it's euphoria, you know.
I think I'd find his accent funny for a good while. Yeah, he's just well not.
Has to wear his glasses.
Accent, but just
yeah, take his shirts off. Shut up with that stupid accent.
He's got like a black over or something.
So yeah. Why is our suspicion?
I have no idea. I have no idea.
That's not like an in joke.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah. He's...
But there is another question about machine guns. That may be more relevant.
What's that one all about?
I can't put this across enough. It was to impress Gokwan.
We played a gig. Played a gig with Gokwan about 2 weeks ago.
You say like he was playing guitar?
Yeah, no, he went.
He was a guest guitarist.
Great solo.
I can just imagine him crowd surfing.
No, it was a big outdoor festival in Preston type thing, which was in the flag market in Preston, daytime thing. It was boiling. It was a lovely day.
Hugh came in his chinos.
And Hugh appeared in his chinos because Gokwan was there.
You know what? I thought it's a warm day. You don't want to wear black because it absorbs heat. Sorry, this is boring, isn't it?
I didn't get that memo.
It absorbs the heat. You don't want to get hot legs. This is what's going to be the interview.
It's consumer advice. That's what people
want
to hear.
Don't tell me, I know about that.
You wear a pair of camel chinos.
I know
about it. It's tan, like beige chinos. It's the look I was going
proper
for.
Proper beige, that's what you want, isn't it? Beige,
it's that's rock and roll, isn't it?
Yeah, it's
beige.
Really rock and roll.
Wearing it with that shirt.
Yeah.
Oh, well, yeah, no.
He did that later in the night.
Yeah, that's true.
We had another gig, so he did,
yeah. Yeah, it didn't work quite so well.
He does have one more question. When is the merchant CDs?
Hopefully we're at Black Forum Festival, which is July.
So you guys got an EP out?
We have. We've got one EP out called Frontier.
We don't have any physical copies of that.
It's all online,
yeah.
Is that the EP that's going to be CD?
So CDs are unlikely to come out. Probably not going to be taking CDs. We'll be hammering the merch. So we'll be getting t-shirts, picks, stickers, caps. Need some caps, definitely.
I mean, if there's a demand for CDs, maybe in the future, possibly.
But the way it's going,
probably not.
It seems to be only my dad that was like, "You're not going to CD for me?"
Yeah.
I'm like, no.
I haven't been asked for a CD once since we started doing it.
So I've asked for
I don't have anything to play a CD on.
In your car.
So
it's more t-shirts and stuff like that.
I think most of the bands these days, that's true.
Yes, of course. There's the only way to really make money now. A lot of venues don't really even fund your petrol money, to be honest with you. So it's
days when a record company would fund your tour.
No, God, no.
Album sales.
That sounds amazing.
Sounds brilliant, yeah.
Unfortunately, you were born in the wrong era.
Yeah, yeah.
But saying that, I think, like I said earlier, I'm excited about the future of Match Music.
Yeah.
Because there are bands like you guys I'm really excited to see tonight.
Yeah, great point.
The
I suppose Yes. I suppose key messages that I'd be looking to get across are, please check us out when we're travelling around the UK. We've got a bit of a break after this gig. We're not gigging again until July. In July we've got festivals and gigs mainly around the northwest, but we're also hoping to travel to London a few times, Yorkshire, which we can't announce anything quite yet, but there might be something going on there, and the southeast more generally as well. Second thing is, please check out our new music video, which is to our track The Secret. And third thing is, there might be a new music video to come, and we might be asking for a helping hand with it. So stay tuned on Facebook. Yeah.
What I would say is that we're a better band live than we are recorded, so it's well worth actually coming to it and see us live.
And go for your chinos.
Yeah. And make sure you wear chinos.
Check out our social media. It's obviously we'll be that's where our videos are, so check out our Facebook, search Building Giants. Oh, yeah, our events. We've also got a website, so go and check that out, buildinggiantsband.com. That's where all our events are on there as well, all our gig pictures or anything like that. Yeah, pretty much check us out on social media, please.
What they said.
Yeah, what essentially what they said. And as and when we do get the merch sorted, so we'll be chucking that on the site as well, so that's a good place to go for that one.
And also stay safe.
No, that's great, guys. So, yeah, just basically check any social media, all the latest news, all the latest things will be on there. Merch is coming very soon.
Yeah.
New announcements coming soon, which is great.
Yep.
I can't wait to see you guys tonight.
Thank you very much.
Have a fantastic show in Camden. Thanks for talking to Two Finger Media.
Cheers, well. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having us.